Hu Tao is the trolley pyro waifu everyone's been waiting for, and she outputs the damage to make it his best girl as well. Her obsession with death and living on the edge reflects in her berserker playstyle, and this playstyle makes her incredibly fun. Today, we're going to be taking an in-depth look at Hu Tao's kit, including talents and constellations, how to best output damage, artifact sets, weapons, and what characters she plays well with. My name is Braxophone, and this is the Ultimate Hu Tao Play Guide. To get started, we're going to take a look at Hu Tao's talents. Hu Tao's basic attack is a 6-hit combo with a high charged attack damage scaling. It's not necessarily close to Jean's charged attack scaling, but it is worth noting. Her charged attack has her take a step back, then thrust forward, causing a delay in damage. When she activates her E, however, this changes to just a forward charge. Hu Tao's E skill is her bread and butter. It increases her attack based on her max HP, and the more you level it up, the more of an attack increase you get. It also converts all of your damage to pyro, and charged attacks apply a damage over time effect called Blood Blossom that lasts for 8 seconds and does damage every 4 seconds. This skill works perfectly with her second Ascension passive because it drops her HP by 30% every use. When you're playing Hu Tao, you want to be mindful of the cooldown of this ability because it's a 16 second cooldown with a 9 second duration, which means that you'll have 7 seconds of downtime between use. This downtime is optimal for switching characters into heal, burst, or just use abilities in general. This ability is also why Hu Tao should be classified as a sub DPS even if she fits as a main DPS with a proper team composition. One last note is that her Blood Blossoms do not proc the Crimson Witch set. Looking at Hu Tao's elemental burst, her Q ability functions similarly to Tartaglia's, where she does a 360 hitting in an AoE. The damage scaling is high, but it's even higher if Hu Tao's HP is below 50%. For each enemy Hu Tao hits, she heals a portion of her HP back that scales with the talent level. The below 50% effect applies to this as well, which increases her healing received. The cooldown is decent at 15 seconds and the energy cost is mid-tier. Moving on to Hu Tao's passives now, Passive 1 is a sub-DPS passive that gives a bonus of 12% crit rate for 8 seconds to any party members except Hu Tao after her E ability ends. This means that after her E ends, the game is essentially encouraging you to swap her out, so knowing this, you should have a character to take the reins for the 7 seconds after Hu Tao's E ends. Passive number 2 is the most essential passive of the 3, since it makes it so that when Hu Tao's HP is below 50%, she gains 33% pyro damage bonus. You want to always have this passive up, so running a shield character with her is encouraged so that way you can use it when she's below 50% HP and not have to worry about taking extra damage. And passive number 3 is Sus. The main thing to gather from these abilities is that you always want to have Hu Tao below 50% health, if possible, to make sure you're getting the most out of her kit. All of her talents take Diligence Books and Whopper Flower Nectar, with her high-level talents taking Shards of Foul Legacy from the Child Fight. Now that we've touched on all of Hu Tao's talents, we can move on to a brief constellation overview. Here we'll discuss which constellations are the best and which ones are maybe worth pulling for if you have the extra pulls to spare and you really love Hu Tao. Constellation 1 is a ton of value for your buck. If you're free to play, don't worry about going for it, but if you're lucky enough to get this constellation, you'll see roughly a 30% DPS increase during your skill phase if you're playing this correctly. It allows you to charged attack at no stamina cost, effectively allowing you to spam your charged attacks and cancel a significantly higher amount. So this constellation is really valuable. Constellation 2 is another damage increase. It's not massive, but every little bit counts. It makes her Blood Blossoms do 10% of Hu Tao's max HP as extra damage from Blood Blossoms on tick. For example, if you have 30k health, it's going to add 3k to each one of your Blood Blossoms. This constellation also allows your Q ability to apply Blood Blossoms as well, so you can hit multiple enemies with it, but most of the time I feel like you're going to be one-hitting smaller enemies with the Q anyways. Good constellation, not entirely necessary though. Constellation number 3 levels up her E skill by 3. Constellation 4 makes Hu Tao increase all of their friendly characters' crit rates by 12% once an enemy affected by Blood Blossom is killed. This constellation is additive with the 12% you get from her Ascension, and it allows you to build a burst DPS mostly crit damage with Hu Tao supplementing the rest of the crit rate. That being said, this constellation is a lot of investment for the small amount of crit rate it gives you. The effect is good, but I don't think it's worth wailing for in my personal opinion, unless we find out that it stacks. And if we do find out that it stacks, I'll let you know in the comments, but I haven't seen any videos on it. Constellation number 5 levels up her Q skill by 3. And constellation number 6 makes it so that she gets an extra chance at survival when her HP gets below 25% or takes lethal damage. Hu Tao won't die as a result of that hit, and her crit rate will be increased by 100%, meaning that if you do have this constellation, you can choose to use Hu Tao only on a 60-second cooldown, but build her full crit damage with no crit rate at all, allowing her to just come in and slap hard once a minute. Hu Tao's resistances are greatly increased for the duration of that 10 seconds. To be honest though, I think it's a fine constellation, but I wouldn't go all in for it unless you're only prepared to use Hu Tao once a minute to take full advantage of it, because ultimately, crit rate boost is great and all, but if you want to take full advantage of it, you're going to need more crit damage. In conclusion for our constellations, Constellation 1 is probably my favorite, which is nice because it's so much more accessible than all of the other ones, but unlike Xiao, at least every constellation is useful and there isn't one that's super redundant to her kit, so I am very glad MiHoYo made these decisions with her kit. Now that we've covered her kit in its entirety, we can talk about DPS rotation and the optimal combo for her. Because there's so much frame data to gather, I actually didn't do this one myself. I went over to the Hu Tao main's Discord where they had made a bunch of documents including the frame data for all of the attacks, and they had come up with a couple different combos that are optimal. The TLDR of the document is that normal into charged attack into dash is the best combination, but it basically deletes your stamina. The reason the combo is good though is because her charged attack has a lot of end lag, but if you dash, you can cancel it a lot faster than if you jump, and because her charged attack does a lot more damage and applies Blood Blossom, it's really good to spam. And this is also why Constellation 1 is so valuable. If you have stamina management issues, you can replace it with normal into charged attack into jump, but the jump is slower than the dash again. And against Ruin Guards, it's worth noting that you don't necessarily need to cancel, you can actually just go normal into charge into normal into charged because their hitbox is so big and you can't pass through it, so it'll automatically stop your motion and you don't have to cancel at all for it. Another rotation you can do if you don't have Constellation 1, or if you have problems with stamina management, as I said before, you can do normal attacks 3 times into charged attack with a dash or jump cancel at the end, because it conserves some stamina, and it's only about an 8% damage loss in comparison to the normal attack into charged. If you're interested in knowing more, there will be a link to the Hu Tao main's Discord in the description below. Now we get to get into the fun stuff though, we're gonna talk about sets and stats. There are a couple sets you can run with Hu Tao to play her optimally, but before you choose a set, you need to figure out if you're going to play Hu Tao in a Melt or Vaporize comp, or if you're going to play her without reactions. We'll go over sets for non-reactionary compositions and reactionary compositions. If you are running a reactionary composition, you'll want to run 4-piece Crimson Witch, since it gives a pyro damage bonus with 2 pieces, and it increases pyro damage further with the 4-piece set when you activate Hu Tao's E-skill. It's also worth noting that you get a bonus to reactionary damage with this set. The only downside to this set is that it doesn't affect your normal attacks at all when your E skill isn't up, so that's probably worth keeping in mind. If you're using her as specifically an always on the field DPS, you are going to lose out on some of the white damage. And one last thing, Hu Tao's Blood Blossoms do not proc Crimson Witch's effect. They're an elemental skill damage, but they're not elemental skill activation. I'll talk about stats and subs after we talk about the other sets. If you're not running a reactionary composition, Lava Walkers is your jam. The 2-piece set isn't super relevant to your damage output, but it gives you a 40% resistance to pyro, and the 4-piece set bonus increases your damage against enemies with a pyro debuff by 35%. So as long as the enemy has pyro on them, they're going to take 35% more damage from your normal attacks as well. The reason you don't want to run reaction damage with Lava Walkers is because when you cause an elemental reaction, the pyro debuff can disappear, which removes that damage bonus temporarily. Also, Crimson Witch directly buffs reactions, so that set is better for that purpose, whereas Lava Walkers is going to be better if you're not doing reactions. And if for some reason you're not able to complete the Crimson Witch set, you can use 2 Crimson Witch and 2 Gladiator, or just 4-piece Gladiator to fill in for the time being, but it's worth noting that these two sets will net you less damage than Lava Walkers or 4-piece Crimson Witch, especially if you do 4-piece Gladiator, because the 4-piece Gladiator set does not allow you to get the 35% damage bonus from charged attacks, which is a huge part of her kit. Speaking of charged attacks though, there's another set you can run that'll also net you a ton of damage, and that is 4-piece Bolide. The 4-piece Super Bolide set gives you a bonus of 40% damage to your charged and normal attacks when you have a shield on, and because Hu Tao benefits a ton from shields when she gets into low health, you can actually build a shield composition with her and take full advantage of the Super Bolide set. Now there are downsides to this set too. You don't get the set bonus unless you have a shield on you, so if your shield characters die or if their shields are on cooldown, you have to worry about not getting the extra damage on Hu Tao, and she also won't be getting any pyro damage bonus, so her Q skill won't actually be doing as much damage as possible. But if you really like shield characters, you have access to some and you're gonna run some with Hu Tao, it might be worth considering going for Bolide. I won't be going for Bolide personally because I prefer reaction damage, but it's there and it's viable. This final set is for burst DPS Hu Tao, and it's actually pretty strong, but you are gonna miss out on all the fun auto attack and E stuff you can do with Hu Tao. For burst support Hu Tao, you want to run 2-piece Snowblast for 20% more damage on your elemental burst, and you want to run 2-piece Lava Walker for a 15% pyro damage increase. If you're gonna do this, you want to have a pyro pyro battery for her because she's not going to be doing much pyro damage herself outside of her Q. The reason I held off on talking about artifact stats is because they're kind of somewhat based on your weapon, but in a general sense they're the same. If you're running a crit rate or crit damage weapon, which is ideal for Hu Tao, you'll want to run HP Sands, pyro damage goblet, and crit damage or crit rate on your circlet. Between crit damage and crit rate, you'll want whichever one will get you closer to a 1-to-2 ratio. For example, if I have a 120% crit damage and 30% crit rate with no circlet, I'll want to use a crit rate circlet to ensure that the uptime for crit hits is optimal. That way my crit rate is 60% and my crit damage is 120%, which is the 1-to-2 ratio. The opposite also applies. If you have a 60% crit rate and 60% crit damage, you want to use a crit damage circlet, etc. And if you don't have a crit circlet, use HP over attack. And if you don't have a crit or HP circlet, attack is fine. You'll get more damage scaling off of Hu Tao's HP though than you will off an attack percent Sands because her attack is really low to start and her HP is where most of her damage scaling comes from when she's in pyro form. The one exception where you'll want to run attack percent Sands is if you run the black tassel weapon. Since at level 90, it gives us 46.6% HP bonus, which is exactly the same as a 5-star HP Sands at max level. So you'll basically just swap those, they're interchangeable. Something to keep in mind with Hu Tao is that she has a cap at 400% of her base attack, meaning once the ratio she takes off of your HP for attack exceeds 4 times her base attack, it'll stop adding. The good news is that it's really hard to hit that 400% cap, so you really don't have to worry about overcapping on it. I believe in the Hu Tao main server there's also a document on this that's describing exactly what you would need to cap out, and it is a lot of effort. For substats, prioritize crit rate and crit damage based on the weapon you're using to maintain the ratio. Following that, HP substats are actually good as well, since you're not going to end up hitting cap unless you get some crazy HP substats and main an HP circlet. As for attack percent versus flat attack though, in some cases, flat attack is actually better because Hu Tao's base attack is low. On screen is a preview of a spreadsheet with exact values and thresholds where flat attack is actually better than attack percent. The document is too large to show all at once, so if you want to see the whole thing, the link will be in the description. In the most general sense possible, flat attack is better in early game and with free-to-play 3-star weapons. Of course, we're all a part of No Defense Gang, and energy recharge is fine, but I've found that Hu Tao's Q cost is pretty low and her energy generation is actually pretty good as well. But that about wraps it up for artifacts. There are builds that are very, very specific that will have different artifact sets, and I'll be releasing videos on that over the next little bit. But for the meantime, for a general reaction build or a pyro build, just whatever's going to be most optimal, that is going to be the sets that we talked about today. Alright, now so weapons are a hot topic for this character because they all apply different stats, and all these different stats make people freak out about how to actually build Hu Tao, so we're going to talk about that a tiny bit. Hu Tao mains has been hard at work finding the best weapons given all the caveats of Hu Tao's kit and reaction, so ladies and gentlemen, I present to you another spreadsheet. So of course, Staff of Homa is the best weapon for Hu Tao hands down, and if you have it, you should use it on her. It's literally her weapon. The reason Homa is good is because it adds to your max HP, and then Hu Tao's entire kit's like, ah yes, max HP go burr, and turns it into attack. Not to mention, Homa has crit damage on it, so it's a really good stat for Hu Tao. The next best on the list is actually the Primordial Jadewing Spear. This one's good because of its passive and crit, so if you got it on Xiao's banner and don't use it for Xiao, slap it on Hu Tao. She'll make good use of it. Following that are the other 5-stars, Vortex Vanquisher and Skyward Spine. They're pretty good, but at Refinement 1, it actually looks like Deathmatch is better than Vortex, just barely, and Skyward by a decent amount. What's actually super interesting is that Deathmatch is the best 4-star at Refinement 1, but other 4-star spears actually beat it out at higher refinements. Specifically, if you have the Lithic Spear with 4 Liyue party members, it beats out Deathmatch at Refinement 2, and Dragon's Bane's in a pretty similar boat, where if you have a reaction party with the Crimson Witch set, Dragon's Bane is better than Deathmatch at Refinement 4. So that's worth considering, you can actually find a use for your Dragon's Banes. The reason my notes on refinement are relevant is because Deathmatch is much harder to refine than Lithic and Dragon's Bane, so if you have those as options, it's probably worth investing into them if you have a couple refinements in. Of course, Lithic Spear is also just good in general without refinement, and at 0 stacks, Black Cliff Pole is probably the next best option. Following Black Cliff is the Royal Spear, and the Royal Spear is the counterpart to Black Cliff in the shop, so if you spent Star Glitter on either of these, they're both pretty viable. All of the weapons we've talked about so far technically aren't free to play though, so you'll be happy to know that one of the most free to play friendly weapons in the game is almost as good as Black Cliff, and that's the White Tassel. The White Tassel has a really low base attack, but because Hu Tao's base is already low and her E scales with HP, it's nearly negligible. So White Tassel not only provides crit rate, but its passive also increases normal attack damage, which means that you're going to get additive scaling right at the end of your calculations. Unfortunately, its passive doesn't apply to charged attacks, but it will still outclass every other free free-to-play spear option, including the 4-star ones. If you're really early game and you haven't gotten White Tassel yet, Black Tassel functions fine too, but it does fall behind White Tassel by a lot. White Tassel can be found in chests around the world for those of you who are free-to-play, and Black Tassel can be obtained from Orban, the blacksmith at Dragonspine Camp. Now that we've discussed weapons and the best options for you, we can move on to character synergies. Hu Tao has a few characters she plays very well with and has quite a bit of flexibility. I won't be discussing full team compositions in this guide because it would take way too much time and this thing's already super long, but I will be releasing other videos with team compositions explained fully in depth for Hu Tao. When running Pyro Resonance, Constellation 1 Xiangling is a good complement to Hu Tao, since Xiangling's Guoba will reduce enemy pyro resistance by 15%. Outside of Xiangling though, I would argue that only Xinyan really complements Hu Tao. Xinyan can shield Hu Tao, which is really important for her at low HP as a saving throw, and since she likes to play as a berserker, it's just really nice. As for Diluc and Klee, however, Hu Tao is a powerful pyro carry, and generally, it's not advised to have two carry characters of the same element, because then you can run into trouble against shields, so I personally would recommend against using both of those. This is really interesting too, Bennett actually doesn't complement Hu Tao well, because Hu Tao wants to be below 50% of health at all times, and Bennett heals with this Q, so I actually advise against Bennett here unless you're trying to one-shot something. Amber is something. You could probably use her as a pyro support in this case, but there's no direct synergy. I was playing around with some cryo users earlier, and I found that Kaya actually isn't super great with Hu Tao, because his Q application is really slow, which leads to inconsistent pyro and cryo auras, and these kind of switch back and forth between Hu Tao and Kaya. Chongyun, however, can be a really great reverse melter with his Q ability, though you probably don't want to use his E skill with Hu Tao, but at the end of Hu Tao's burst window, you can switch over to Chongyun and just reverse melt with his Q, and then switch back to Hu Tao. I know we all memed on Tecton for the Ganyu support thing, but she does an okay job of it with Hu Tao. She kinda has the same problem as Kaya, where the melts are inconsistent, but because it's an AoE, it's not as big of a deal. And finally, Diona and Chi-Chi are fine if you set up cryo application for Hu Tao's Q, but outside of that, there's no direct sort of synergy, it's just about setting her up. Hu Tao is probably a huge fan of Geogang though, since they give a ton of shields. Xiangli and Albedo are both kings when it comes to Hu Tao's survivability and damage output. They're gonna complement Hu Tao well in that regard, because they're gonna always be able to have shields up on her when she gets low. Noelle is also an amazing backup for Hu Tao, since Noelle's Ascension 1 passive will give an emergency shield to characters who fall below 30% health once per 60 seconds. So this means when you cast Hu Tao's E and you end up going below 30% health, you're gonna get a nice, bulky Noelle shield. The one Geo I don't necessarily think provides synergy is Ningguang, but she makes a good secondary DPS to Hu Tao, so she's okay. As for Electrogang, Fischl is a good support if you're not running Melter Vaporize, but if you are, she might get in the way of that. Generally speaking though, Fischl is good. Beto Constellation 1 is also good for the shield it provides when you use her Q, so that's worth taking into account. The only downside is that when you hit enemies with overload, they go flying backwards, so it makes you use more stamina to keep up with them. As for Anemo Gang, there's no direct synergy except for with Venti, but that one should be pretty obvious since crowd control is king, and Venti literally groups everything. Finally, we come to Hydro Gang. Probably the most important thing to know about Hydro is that Jingxiu applies Hydro more consistently in his Q than Hu Tao can apply Pyro, which actually makes him perfect aura for Hu Tao, because it means every time you're hitting with Hu Tao, the water blades are going to overtake the pyro and you'll be able to reverse vape. He and Hu Tao are probably one of the strongest combinations in the game, and I highly advise you run Jingxiu as a support for Hu Tao. Tartaglia is also great with Hu Tao because he can be swapped in for a vaporize burst between Hu Tao's E uses, and he won't have consistent vaporize like Jingxiu, but his Q will do a ton of damage in burst windows. Also worth mentioning that his E skill is on that interesting cooldown, so you can kind of rotate him and Hu Tao. If you've made it this far, congratulations, you can now graduate from the School of Hu Tao. That's all the information I have for you on Hu Tao, and it should basically cover everything you need to know to get started on that character, build her perfectly, and have her doing a ton of damage for your team. So if you're hearing this, thank you so much for watching this video. If you've enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a rating and or a comment down below and let me know. If you guys think I missed anything, make sure to let me know in the comments down below. If you enjoy Genshin Impact content in general and would like to see more guides and content like this, make sure to follow me on YouTube by hitting the subscribe button down below. And if you're interested in live Genshin content, I go live on Twitch 2 to 3 days a week at twitch.tv/braxophone. Thanks again for watching, and I'll catch you guys later. Have a wonderful week.